Hello everybody, my name is Anmol Birring and today is March 11, 2024 and today's lecture will be on making the phased array scan plan. So last time we covered PAUT calibration and I just wanted to show you the PAUT calibration sheet, you know, what it looks like. This is a PAUT calibration sheet. And on this one, what we have is the PAUT, the pipe which has to be inspected, which is a 12 inch, the PAUT calibration block or the calibration pipe with the notches. So for the 12 inch, we are using a 10 inch pipe with 10% notches. And here is the phased array setup, the probe, the frequency, active aperture, and the focal depth. And the sweep angle is from 38 degrees to 72 degrees. So in order to make sure that your calibration is valid, what needs to be done, like I discussed in the last lecture of February 24th, is that you have to take the measurements at 40 degrees, 50, 60, and 70 to make sure that you're getting an amplitude on the ID notches and the OD notch, which is about 80%. So here we have 82, 83, 80, and 79. So this is an acceptable calibration. And this is on the OD notch, full V path, and this is also acceptable. Now, what we have is an unacceptable calibration, which is shown here. And in this case, we have at 40 and 50, it is acceptable. It's like 80% and 83% here. However, at 60 degrees and at 70 degrees, we are getting amplitudes which are lower than, significantly lower than 80%. So here we have 62% and 53%. So if you get these kinds of numbers on the ID notch and the OD notch, then this calibration is not acceptable. So this is step number one. As far as the PAUT inspection is concerned, is to make sure that you have a valid calibration and your TCG is showing 80% for all the angles and for all the depths, which is the ID notch and OD notch, to be about 80 plus minus 5%. Now let's go to the next step, which is the scan plan. This is a very big issue right now, as far as the scan plan is concerned. And what I've seen is that many people will show a scan plan with a probe sitting here, and they will show that the whole weld is getting illuminated. So they will have a scan plan from 40 degrees or 38 degrees to 72 degrees, and they will show these angles like that, and they will show that the whole weld has been flooded with sound or has been illuminated with sound. So they are saying that they are getting full 100% weld coverage. The issue is that even though they may be illuminating the whole weld, the question is, are we seeing all the flaws? So if you illuminate the whole weld like this, you will see the root crack, you will see the toe crack with the reflection going here, and you will also see the slab, which is here by the sound going here and getting reflected and going to the slag. The issue is that if you just keep the probe here at the X1 location, then the issue is with the detection of the lack of fusion flaws, the lack of fusion. So I've shown here four lack of fusion flaws, L1, L2, L3, and L4. Now, if I do a scan plan with one offset setting, which is X1, then according to this setup, all I will see is the L2 lack of fusion. Because remember, the sound has, when it is incident on lack of fusion, which is a planar flaw, will reflect back. Angle of incidence equals to angle of reflection. So if it's, in order to see this, it has to hit at 90 degrees for the sound to be reflected back here and back to the probe. Now, if I just keep the probe here and then scan it, now if you look at this lack of fusion L3, the sound is going here and then it's reflecting here. The reflected sound is not going back to the probe. Unlike L2, where the sound is going here, it goes here, it's 90 degrees to the lack of fusion, it comes back on the same path and goes back to the probe. So L2 is detected, L3 is not detected, because the incident beam is here, the reflected beam is right here, so it doesn't go back to the probe. And the same happens with L4 and L1. So as I'm showing here now in this table, is that these are the angles which I've shown here, angle 1, 2, 3, 4, 38, 50, 60, and 72. And for the index positions X1, I can see the toe crack and the root crack are detected at this index position X1. I can see the slag is detected. L2 is detected. The lack of fusion is detected, L2. However, L1, L3, and L4 are not detected. So the important thing is that if I scan with one index position, even though I may actually illuminate the whole weld, even though I may be showing that I have 100% weld coverage and I'm flooding the whole weld, I'm not getting the sound reflecting back from the lack of fusion flaws. So what needs to be done is that you have to take this probe and run it at index position X1 and then run it at index position X1 minus 6 millimeter, X1 plus 6 millimeter, and X1 plus 12 millimeters. So run a scan here and here and here and here. So basically, you have to run at every 6 millimeters to get full coverage, or a good coverage, I would say, of the lack of fusion flaws. Now, if you are looking for smaller lack of fusion flaws, then you have to reduce this pitch, which is the 6 millimeters, you may have to reduce it to 4. So that you have to decide on your own. But basically, in this lecture, what I wanted to emphasize is that a single index position is not the right way to do it, the phased array. And if you go to manual UT, remember in manual UT, when we did manual UT with 60 degrees or any other angle, we don't take a scan at one location. We actually move the probe back and forth so we have full coverage of the weld. So in a way, this is actually a very good scan plan for weld coverage, because we are going back and forth and we are sweeping the beam over the whole fusion phase to see all the lack of fusions. And similarly, in order to get the similar scan plan, we have to do the same thing here, is that we scan at position X1, then X1 minus 6 millimeters, X1 plus 6, and X1 plus 12, to get not only the full illumination of the weld, but also to make sure that we can detect all the lack of fusion flaws, which are shown here as L1, L2, L3, and L4. So I hope this clarifies it, because many PAUT inspectors are not following this approach. They just go with one position and assume that they're getting all the flaws in the weld. And thanks a lot. And then sooner or later, I will have some more lectures on PAUT or UT of stainless steel welds also. So looking forward to seeing you again, and thank you very much.